Hey there. Welcome back to Techna Anima.
Power that off for a second.
My name's Isaiah, and today I'm going to be going over how I 3D modeled, assembled, designed, painted the whole nine yards of these motorized Chainsaw Man arms and this motorized Chainsaw Man helmet. Motorized for now, I got to swap the motor in it and do some more electronic stuff on that. We're going to go over the circuit diagram, some of the painting. I'm going to show you the electronic components that I put into these, and we are going to, we're just going to go over all that stuff. Let's have a fun time. All right, let's go make some stuff.
Alright, so first I started off with some 3D modeling. I used Fusion 360 to 3D model the chainsaw arms and the helmet. Seen here, you can actually see some of the original chainsaw arms, and I just did a slight modification to the original design, changed up some parts of the frame, added a space for the new trigger. I'll probably make one more redesign, and that will just be to include the 3D printed chain links to go around. But because the 3D printed chain links will interface with the sprockets a lot better. And that way I'll be able to move them laterally without worrying about like the belt falling off, which did happen if I moved around too fast while I was wearing the costume. All of the components for the chainsaw arms and the helmet were assembled using a JB weld. Preferably I would have used like a two-part epoxy that wasn't JB weld, just because JB weld is like kind of gross, but it gets the job done. Normally what I would prefer to use is like a two-part like Gorilla epoxy, because I think that's like a pretty easily accessible one, and it already has the two tubes connected, so you can just squeeze them both out and mix them together at the same time. So that's what I prefer to use typically. Alright, so here's a very rough circuit diagram that I used for the chainsaw arms. As you will very quickly find out, I don't claim to be an electrician. I think this is how these were supposed to go, and then let's say this is the motor that I had. So we have the power going from the battery over to a switch, which went directly to the motor, which then reconnects to the opposite terminal of the battery. The switch that I used here actually was a continuous switch, but you could swap that out with a momentary switch if you wanted to. Very, very simple. I didn't add any complicated things. If I wanted to slow down the speed of the motorized arms, I could have added like resistors and things. After the assembly, I went over and sanded and painted all of the components, put some primer on things. I used a laser cutter to cut out all the spikes because it was way easier than sweatshopping that labor out. Did some final painting on the helmet and then took it over to the electronic station to wire some stuff together for the arms and the helmet.
All right, thank you so much for joining me, and I hope you found this tutorial very informative. I'm definitely going to make more tutorials for some of the other things I build. I do plan on making my 5-string Marceline axe base. I think that might be the next big one I do. After that, I plan on doing my my War Machine Iron Man suit with like some custom colors on there. I'm gonna add my own personality to it, of course. So stay tuned for those will be the bigger projects. And in between, you're probably gonna see some of the smaller things that I do when I'm supposed to be doing homework instead. All right, well, thanks and see you next time.
What's going on, guys? It's your boy, sleep deprivation. What's going on, guys? It's your boy, mildly anemic.